I'm gonna make a run for it. Man, looks like I'm busted again. Hey, girls, what did I do this time?
I think you'd enjoy that way too much.
Yeah, tell you the truth, I lost my license 2 months ago. I don't have any insurance on this, so my tags, they're expired.
Well, good thing you're not on a public roadway right now. Good thing this is private property.
I was going to make a run for it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, but I give up.
I'll put this baby against yours.
All right, now let me hop in the back.
You want to hop in the back?
Yes.
Hey, I'm sorry, guys. We'll finish this video some other time when I get out. I'm gonna need bail money. That's the way we start the mornings at Dragon Man's. Whew, boy, that was a lot of fun. Can't get too much traction on the gravel here, but this whole chassis here is made out of 4130 chrome alloy tubing. It's got a Speedway T-bucket front end, Wellwood brakes, custom radiator. That's aluminum radiator. We got the Hemi motor and the we got the Holley carburetors, 750 carburetors, the Moonham blower, and that's a 502 cubic inch Hemi motor. It's got a B&M hydro transmission and narrowed 9-inch Ford 411 gears rear end. Those tires are 18 inches thick, and when my parachute does open, it says, "You lose." And that's the end of that. Then I turn around and collect the check. Okay, this is my homemade coffin car. You know, if you guys watched The Monsters years ago, you see Herman Munster used to have a coffin car, and I always liked the coffin car. He was a big hit. It really impressed me. So, we had to make one. This here's my coffin car. The hardest part of making this car was sneaking over to the cemetery 1:30 in the morning and digging up the coffin. But it's a real old coffin. We got it from a grave from the late 1800s. And it really cleaned up good. We have it painted. It's got a 350 Corvette motor in it with dual quads, a turbo 400 transmission, a boxed homemade frame, and a Chevy 411 rear. Disc brakes in the front, drum brakes in the back. And the way to get in here, we had to cut the coffin, so this here opens. We put heavier hinges on there. It's got a T-bucket front end, Wellwood disc brakes, and this is a moon tank. This is air scoops, and this is really a blast to drive. This has a parachute too in the back, just in case the brakes fail. You never know. But you know what the hardest part of building this was?
Video cameras love her this week.
You know what the hardest part was? Digging up the coffin. And here's my dragster. You never seen my dragster, did you?
I think it was out of plastic last time.
Oh, it's right here.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
Your plate is expired now.
Yeah, street legal.
Your plate's expired.
Oh, I got a sticker. Yeah, I'm not.
That green stands out.
Yeah.
Come on, look at these.
Isn't that neat? I was just driving this around. My brother made a video.
Oh, hi, buddy.
You never seen a museum, huh?
Yeah, you took me Ryan here a couple weeks ago.
Oh, okay.
And then you walked us through the back, so.
I got motorcycle baffles in the pipes. Mm. It's got headlights, seat belts, threaded tires, stoplights.
God, so you fit?
I just fit.
That is so crazy.
Yeah, I just fit. Yep. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna start it.
Okay.
Midget would fit perfect in here.
Yeah, just got out of jail. This is Thursday morning, and I met John over here. He needed a job. We both got out at the same time, and you're gonna be a target holder.
All right, I appreciate it.
Okay, you'll make $35 an hour. If you run back and forth, I'll give you $55.
Okay.
Okay?
Sounds good.
Okay, all right, you're hired.
Appreciate it.
Well, it feels good to get out, you know?
Yeah,
these cops here, you know, I was doing 110 miles an hour, but it was on my property. You know, and then they wanted to give me a ticket because I didn't have any hubcaps on my dragster, and the nuts were showing. You know, isn't that ridiculous?
Yeah.
The nuts were showing.
Yeah. You know, I like to show my nuts off a lot too.
I'll tell you, that's Colorado for you.
Yeah, it is.
All right, come on, we'll put you to work.
Appreciate it.